Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about quantitative inheritance. First, we should know quantitative trait. Quantitative trait is a specific characteristic that are determined by multiple genes. It is influenced by environmental factor. Example is the yield. Loci involved to influence this trait are known as QTLs or quantitative trait loci. These are also called metric traits. Produce continuous variation. They widely influenced by environmental condition. Each gene has such a minor effect that could be measured by various statistical methods only at the place of Mendelian methods. Types of quantitative trait. Continuous trait, continuous graduation from one phenotype to the next. Continuum of phenotypes, example, growth rate, crop yield, and weight. Meristic trait, phenotype falls into discrete, integral categories or discontinuous. Example are ability to roll tongue. Threshold trait, only two or few phenotypic classes, but their inheritance is determined by multiple gene and environment. Expression implies affected individual has liability over threshold. Example are diabetes and certain cancer. Now the things which comes under continuous variation are height, skin pigment, weight, and coat color. These are all examples of continuous traits. Continuous trait do not fall into discrete category. In general, their values in population follow normal distribution, also known as Gaussian distribution or bell curve. This curve are characterized by a mean, which is the midpoint, and the variation and the variance is the width. After standard deviation, the square root of variance is used to measure the curve width. Some of the example for discontinuous trait, they are hairline or earlobe, which could be either attached or unattached, tongue rolling, either they can roll, some people can roll the tongue and some cannot roll their tongue. So these are all examples of discontinuous trait. It is also called as meristic traits. Mendelian trait or comes under discontinuous trait. Example for this discontinuous trait is Hitchhiker thumb, or where you can bend the thumb more compared to the regular thumb or a normal thumb. Characters of quantitative genes. A single gene or allele have a minute effect on phenotype. The individual locus among the complete gene cascade for a trait segregate as Mendelian method. Crossing over occur between genes to create continuous variation. Polygene have pleiotropic effect, deleterious to changing various factors of environment. Quantitative inheritance is also called blended inheritance. Quantitative gene, there are dominant polygenic allele which contribute to the expression of the trait is called contributing allele, while the recessive polygenic allele are also known as non-contributing allele. Examples of non-heritable trait are language you speak, trait that result from physical damage. Examples for heritable trait like dimple, hip dysplasia in dogs, mass of the brain, myopia. These are all examples of heritable traits. Quantitative inheritance. Twin study. Theoretically, any phenotypic difference between identical twin are environmental. Phenotypic difference between fraternal twin can be due to both environmental and genetic difference. If heritability is high, identical twin will normally be very similar for a trait. fraternal twin will be less similar. If heritability is low, identical twin may not be much more similar than fraternal twin. If variation for a trait is completely heritable, identical twin should have a correlation near 1. Fraternal twin should have a correlation near 0.5. The possible origin of polygene depends on duplication of chromosome part, polyploidy or increase in chromosome number, mutation producing genes having similar effect. Difference, see, if you take the difference between monogenic, which is a qualitative, and a polygenic, which is a quantitative inheritance, as responsible for responsible found in respectively, which is found in P by Mendel and Tobacco. So in case of a monogenic inheritance, what happens is that if a parent, one is recessive and one is dominant, when both are crossed, in F1 generation, dominant character will be expressed, and in the F2 generation, where first we self the F1 generation, then in F2 generation we get both recessive and dominant character. Whereas in case of polygenic inheritance, which is a quantitative inheritance, here when you cross a recessive parent with a dominant parent, here instead of a dominant character, what we get is an intermediate in F1 generation. Then when selfing of this F1 generation, that is intermediate, will be done, which gave rise to F2 generation, where you can see both recessive as well as dominant expression of the gene. Along with it, intermediate is also will be produced in more amount. See, this is represented by the quantity of intermediate, which is more compared to recessive and dominant one. Difference between quantitative and qualitative gene. In case of qualitative gene, it is governed by trait of kind, whereas in case of quantitative gene, it is governed the trait of degree. The qualitative gene showed discrete phenotypic class and display discontinuous variation, whereas quantitative gene display continuous variation. The qualitative gene is governed by two or more alleles of a single gene, whereas in quantitative gene, many non-allelic genes are involved, least or not influenced by environment. Whereas in case of quantitative gene, environment affect polygene variously. Counts and ratio are significant tool for analysis in case of qualitative gene. Whereas in quantitative gene, various statistical method is required to analyze them. Then in case of qualitative gene, individual mating and progeny test is required for improvement. Whereas in case of quantitative gene, population with all possible mating is useful for improvement. Some of the examples of quantitative gene or quantitative inheritance are kernel color in wheat. As discussed in multiple factor hypothesis, phenotypic ratio is 1:4:6:4:1. Another example is skin color in human. Depending on the genotype, it could be either mulatto color, which is an intermediate form, or albino white skin color. So depending on that genotype, it varies. So here in this table, you can see the genotype, genotypic frequency, phenotype, and phenotypic frequency. Next example is height in man. Complex trait involve 10 pair of gene, tallness governed by recessive gene, dwarfness governed by dominant gene. They show normal distribution.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.